Welcome, I'm Antje, the owner of Smart Design Embroidery, and today I'm going to show you how to make my mousepads. You may have seen them around, they are very popular, and I have them in my shop for a long time, a few years now, and I use them every day, every single day I will use them. They are machine washable. The great thing about them is they are completely done on your embroidery machine. There is no additional sewing required, and they have this hand rest included. So today I'm showing you how to make these mouse pads. And remember, this is the original file. I designed the file, and only with my designs you could get the very high quality proper instructions with step-by-step pictures, easy to understand even for beginners, so you won't struggle when you're making this mouse pad. And if you have any questions at all, just send me a message, leave a comment under the video, or join my Facebook group. I will put the link into the box below the video. Join my Facebook group and just talk to our other fans and customers, and yeah, we're looking forward to see your projects you make with our designs. See you later, bye! So before we can start, we need to make our template for the cushion, and for that I have a embroidery design included in the download, so you can use that file to stitch out the template on cutaway stabilizer, and then you have a template that you can use over and over again when you make mouse pads for friends, or even for sale. You can sell the finished items, of course. So first hoop your cutaway stabilizer and stitch out the pattern for the cushion. So this is the outline for the pattern, for the template, and we cut this one out just along the seam we just stitched, and then we can use that to cut out the sponge or whatever you use as a filling for the cushion. So here's your template. And because it's cutaway stabilizer, it's long lasting, like you can use it over and over again. So next step is you need your sponge or your filling material, like upholstery foam or any kind of foam will work. And you need a sharp knife. Be careful with the next step. You have to actually cut off the rough side, the scrub side. And it should not be wider than 1 centimeter, so roughly 1.5 cut, and it really pays if you're using a sharp knife. As you can see, just goes through like butter, very easy. So then take your template, place it on the foam, on the surface, on the top, and then just mark the outline. See that here? No, it's not a very good pen for that. Let's have a look for something better. Okay, this one works. This is not the best pen anymore, but for drops like that, it's just perfect. Right, once around. Doesn't have to be too perfect, because you're going to cut the upper edges anyway to make it like give it a round shape on the upper edges. So next step is using your scissors and cutting out the shape like that. Okay, go around, shape it a little bit. And it really doesn't matter if you're cutting it too a little bit smaller than the template is, but it shouldn't be larger than a template. So if you place a template on top, you can always check the size and even the bottom. What I'm going to do now is I'm going in a 45 degree angle around on the top, and make the edges smooth. And I'm doing it only on the top, but it gives the finished cushion a nicer shape once you've done the mouse pad. So that looks pretty good to me. This is the prepared filling for the cushion, and we can now go ahead and start with the mouse pad itself. I hooped wash away stabilizer as a double layer. A double layer because I want to ensure that the design doesn't move when I'm doing the quilting and the satin stitch at the end of the design. So it needs to be firmly hooped, not as loose as it is here. I will just fix that one in a second. You will also need a layer of batting in the size of your design, and one piece of top fabric. That's the part that you see later when the mouse pad is finished. You will need a piece of fabric for your cushion, which I'm using later as I show you. You will need that piece of foam that you just cut and shaped before. Also a piece of back fabric, so for the back of the mouse pad. That can be cheap calico or any other not expensive fabric, because you won't see it anyway at the end. And if you wish, that's optional, you can also use a piece of non-slip fabric or material. This is like kind of a shelf liner. So I'm using my mouse pad since I first designed them, like this one here. I don't have any anti-slip material underneath, and it just stays in place. It doesn't slip when I'm working because I rest my hand here, so you don't really need that. That is totally up to you. I would suggest just play with it and try. I will use it today to show you how to attach that, but usually I'm not using that stuff at all. So let's go and start with the mouse pad. The first sequence to get the outline for the design. Once you stitch the outline, you place the batting and the top fabric with the right side up as a sandwich onto the outline. So you just ensure that the fabrics are covering the outline completely on all corners. Right. The design is usually centered in the hoop. And the reason why I'm doing the first step is the outline is, if you're not using the hoop size that is meant to be for that design you're stitching, but you're using a larger hoop, you want to know where to place the fabrics. And to take the guessing out of the drop, I just inserted the first step to stitch the outline to show you where the fabrics are going to be placed. Okay. So you see I'm not working with any fabric glue or something like that. I just place it on top. You slow your machine down if you can, and then you stitch the second sequence, which is sewing the material onto the stabilizer. Just hold it down a little bit outside of the stitching area so you don't get with your fingers close to the needle. Thank you. stippled stitch, the quilt stitch inside the design. Stippling stitch is done now. Next step is to work on the cushion for the headrest. It's marking the area where you place the foam. So you now need your cushion that you have prepared earlier. Check the outline. Check if it is fitting in this space inside of the outline here. If it is still a little bit too large, you can cut it off. That's what I noticed here. I have a little edge that is overlapping, which I don't like to have that way. I just want to have it a little bit smaller than the outline which I have just stitched. So I'm just making it a little bit smaller, you know, and that looks much better. Okay, clean up the mess and then we go on. Place the foam on into the outline, into the inside of the cushion area, with the flat side down and the shaped area up. And on top of that, you place your fabric that you want to use to cover the cushion nice and tight, and you use some tape to keep it down. You can also use pins, but you have to stay outside the embroidery area, otherwise your needle will hit the pins, which is not a very good idea anyway. So I'm just taking down the fabric here with my tape, my masking tape, to make sure it's not moving. Stay in place like that. Stay where it is. And next step is to slow down the machine if you can. And take it easy. And also use a pen or a wood stick or something to stay close to the pin, to the cushion. Don't use your fingers. You don't want to come underneath the needle with your fingers. Okay, so I'm slowing down my machine. And now, let's start. So the next step is to sew a seam inside the shape close to the foam, and the reason for that is that the satin stitch, which is later covering the corner here, has enough space and it's not going into the foam. So actually that is an extra securement for the cushion. Can you see that? It's already taking shape. So you remove the tape now and cut away the excess of the fabric. So you go close to the outer seam, don't cut into the seam, you go close to the outer seam and cut away the excess of the fabric just like you would do it for any applique you're doing, okay? I hope you can see that in the camera. It's a little bit tight here with the space. Oh, hang on, I just zoom out. You can see it a little bit better. That should work. Alright, so stay close to the seam, as I said. The closer you cut to the seam, the nicer your satin stitch will turn out. So try to work very, very accurate. Take your time, don't rush, and especially using sharp scissors will help a lot. So with a blunt scissor you won't have any joy for doing that job. Right, so I'm showing you this one quickly. This is the later orientation for the cushion, okay? And we now can go ahead and stitch out the satin stitch for the cushion. So now you see why I did the inner seam. The needle has just enough space to move around the edge. Okay. Next step is to add the fabric and, if you wish, the non-slip material to the back. All right, I'll take you over to the cutting table and show you what I'm doing next. Okay, so you have your hoop here. You leave the mouse pad in the hoop. Don't unhoop the material, okay? Turn it to the back. Place your covering fabric for the back on the hoop, and best way is to ensure everything is nice and clean before, if you're using bright fabrics. Also, if your fabric has a right and the left side, like a nice and the wrong side, the nice side goes up, and the outline of the mouse pad again needs to be covered. Next, if you going to use any anti-slip material, non-slip material, that needs to go on top of the fabric. All right, if you don't use that one, you can leave that one. Don't have to use that. Just follow the steps I'm doing now, only with the fabric. But if you're using that fabric, just put it on top, and then you're going to fix the layers at the back. And for that you need strong tape. I'm using painter's tape here, like masking tape, because you have to make sure that the fabric stays in place and doesn't move anywhere, right? So I'm placing tape at the corners, on all four corners. And you ensure everything is nice and flat. And I also use some additional tape on the top and bottom, because I don't want to want the fabric to move somewhere at all. Right. Okay, a little bit more here and there. Better be safe than sorry. Alright. Okay, so prepared for the next step, which is the second last you're going to stitch out. Ensure everything lays flat, okay? And now we can go ahead with the next step. So, last step before you stitch out the satin border is to cut away the fabric and the batting at the front, and the fabric and the non-slip material at the back. Okay, so just like an applique again, the pretty much the same. You have to stay close to the seam. You don't cut into the seam. You try not to move the project in the hoop. Don't pull on a project or on a stabilizer, nothing. Just work carefully and everything will be fine. First you have to remove the tape, of course. Right. Fantastic. So now we go and cut close to the seam, as I said. So, and don't cut into the seam, just close to it. Like that. Right. And also don't cut into the stabilizer. So you don't accidentally cut through the stabilizer here, just hold your scissors flat. Go around the shape slowly and close to the seam. And take your time, no rush here. It's not a competition, especially when you're doing it the first time. Just take your time and enjoy doing it. Enjoy the moment. That's what the back should look like, as you can see. Alright, nice and clean. And at the front, you're doing exactly the same. To make it easy, you can either cut the top fabric first and then you go to the bedding, but you also can cut both layers together. That's what I'm going to do. Just don't pull on the fabric, alright? If you're pulling too much, you may pull the stabilizer and you replace the or displace the design in the hoop and the final stitches won't match. So be careful, all right? Okay. Looks nice, doesn't it? Nice front, nice back. So the final step is to stitch the satin border all around the outside. Okay, so I'm showing you that one now. And we're going to finish that mouse pad. Have you finished mouse pad front and back, nicely done. And the only thing you have to do is now cut it out and wash away the rest of the stabilizer along the satin border, or you wash the complete out mouse pad if you like. What I'm doing here, you just take it out of the hoop, just remove the hoop, and then you just go close along the seam. Don't cut into the seam. Your mouse pad is finished. Look at it. Nice and comfy. Large enough to work around. This is the 6x10. 26x16 cm. 6x10 inch. And it's nicely done.